Hey guys, now I know all of you content creators are always looking for ways to keep your audience engaged and entertained with lots of content. But in many cases, we see quality go down as quantity goes up. All of that ends today. I'm going to show you some editing hacks that'll give you professional quality Instagram stories or reels. And for those of you that want consistent branding on your content, make sure you keep watching because there's an extra special hack in the middle of this tutorial. Now let's hurry because I promised you in the title that we would make 5 professional quality stories or reels in 4 minutes. Before we get into it, like and subscribe, download the software, and as always, work smarter, not harder. Now, before we start, we need to learn how to use Promeo. Since we don't have a lot of time and the clock is already ticking, let's hurry. First, we're going to access the templates in the Promeo app. I'm going to slide across the design section at the top of the app to find the media type and aspect ratio that I want. Let's say I want to create a thumbnail for a YouTube video or a post on Instagram, even create my own ads for Instagram Reels. I have so many options and the way to edit them is all the same. Anyway, in this case, I'm going to pick the story and reels option. Then I'll filter based on the theme of my video. So for my first story, I'm going to make a post featuring food. So I'll type in food, then scroll through until I find one that I like. I'm going to pick this one with the pizza, even though I'm not going to post about pizza, but don't worry, you can edit any of the elements in the template. Then you're going to click through the preview to get to the editing page. You can explore the different elements by pressing on different spots in the template. For this, we're going to change out the video with my own. For example, let's just say I'm making a video about street food. I'm going to replace the background video with a video I took while getting street food by pressing the media button in the main ribbon and then the replace button. For this particular template, it asks for a 15-second video, so I'll select one of my longer videos and then use the sliding video bar to pick out the part that I want. Then I'm going to delete the shop now button by selecting and pressing the X, and then click the add button and then select image. I'll select the photo I took of the food, then click cut out. Now this is where we let the AI do the work for you. Once you're in the cutout section of the photo edit, click auto, then the AI power tool will create a cutout of the main subject in the photo. After that, I can adjust the cutout to my liking. For this project, I want my design to look a little more quirky, so I'm going to go into the AI style button and slide through to pick the filter I like. Once I select one, I'm going to apply it to the food to make it look a little more like a cartoon. This AI style option can be easily applied to both faces and backgrounds. Then I'll go to the animation button and put a transition into my cutout so that it animates into the screen with the other elements in the template. Next, I'm going to change the wording to match my street food theme. Let's call it street food and chill. For added style, I can also adjust the text however I want by changing the color and font. For the last few finishing touches, I'm going to delete the logo as well as the order now because we don't need that for this story. And then add some music, something that screams street food. No, not that one. Not that one either. Yeah, that one. Okay, now that I'm done, I'm gonna upload straight into Instagram and then it'll automatically save onto my device. Ah, look at the time. Okay. Before we move on to the next 4 stories, I'm gonna show you an extra special hack to save you time, especially for those of you that want consistent branding on your content. On the upper right-hand corner of the app, go into the settings and scroll down to Brand Kit. In this feature, add your logo. From there, your brand colors should automatically pop up. Then under Brand Fonts, select a heading and body text font that best represents your branding. Now go back in and start a new project. When you click into a template and go into the preview, there will be a button that says Apply Brand Kit. This will apply your logo, colors, and chosen fonts into the elements in the template. Then you can either save it as is or adjust and replace things as you want. And that just saved me loads of time. Now on to the other stories. For the other stories, I'm going to make a yoga style story, an outfit of the day, a travel, and a lifestyle story. Okay, yoga. Apply brand kit, replace the photo with my own, then let's change the title to PowerDirector Yoga Day. Now let's change the background colors a little bit because they're too bright right now, and done. Next, outfit of the day. Change the photo, and then let's change the background color as well. Change the Instagram handle, then let's change the title to PowerDirector #OOTD. And done. Okay, now travel. Let's do this one. Okay, now apply brand kit. Okay, then let's follow the same steps to change out the video in the background. I'll need at least a 12-second video. And this coincidentally, this video happens to be from New York, so let's keep the label on it. And then let's change the music. And now, okay, let's choose this one and we're done. Okay, now onto the final one. Okay, let's do lifestyle. Let's search life and then we'll pick this one. I'm not going to apply the brand kit to this one, so let's just get into it. I'll replace the words on top to say 10 ways to de-stress, and then I'll change the alignment and center it some more Then let's change the background and pick a video that is longer than 10 seconds. Let's do this one. Ah! Phew, that was a close one. If you found any of that helpful, give us a like and subscribe for more. And click in the link to download for free and try out the software for yourself. Links should be all over my face right now and also in the description. All right, see you next time.